Welcome, everyone. Welcome. Thank you so much for coming. My name is Patricia Donaldson. I'm the president and CEO of the Hawthorne Chamber of Commerce. If you would all stand for the invocation, please.
A great day in the city of good neighbors. This is a grand mixer here. Let's ask the blessing. Lord, we thank you for an opportunity to gather here in this great city and our beloved South Bay and Hawthorne. And we ask your blessing on everybody in this room. We ask your blessing on our families, on our businesses, on all of our kids and grandkids. And we ask your blessing on our mayor and council and for this city and for the Chamber of Commerce. Amen.
We're going to pray for the language of the heaven in Spanish. Heaven. Señor y Padre nuestro que estás en los cielos, te damos muchas gracias por la bendición que nos has dado. Poder reunirnos en este día tan especial, Señor, conmemorador. Y sobre todo, Señor, tan significativo para la ciudad de Hawthorne y sus alrededores. Te damos gracias por cada presente, por cada departamento representado en esta ciudad. Empezando, Señor, con la seguridad, departamento de policía, de bomberos, de cada concilio de la ciudad, concejal, sobre todo sobre nuestro nuevo mayor, Señor, de esta ciudad, lo ponemos en tus manos. Y sobre todo, Señor, por cada miembro administrativo, Señor, que representa esta gran ciudad, los ponemos en tus manos y confiamos que la bendición y la protección tuya será siempre cada día de nuestras vidas. Lo pedimos en Cristo Jesús. Amén. Amén.
Okay, I'm going to introduce to you before we start the color guard the most powerful man in California, and that is Ray Cordova.
I wrote that. Please remain standing for the color guard. We're honored to have with us again today the Hawthorne Police Department color guard. Post the colors. To have with us today for the color guard, Lieutenant Scott Swain, Officer Jose Gomez, Officer Sarah Lewis, and Officer Jeff Salmon. And before we do the Pledge of Allegiance, I would like to ask, are there any veterans in the audience with us today? Please join me up here on the stage. All the veterans, please. Now we know why we're in such great shape. Military veterans may use the hand salute. All others, your hand over your heart. I pledge allegiance to the flag, the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Order. Detail. Face. Forward.
Hurt. You may be seated.
I'm ready.
Hit it.
For the second most powerful man in California,
Jan
Vogel.
All right. Thank you, Pat. Alex Vargas. Where is Alex Vargas? Hey, Alex Vargas, you made it, huh? I mean, this is a big deal. So, your mother and father gave us some pictures from the archives that we wanted to share with this group today, and some of them are very sentimental, so thank you, Mr. and Mrs. Vargas. And now, the first one is going to be, don't put it up yet, but the first one is going to be when Alex has always been motivated, and he's always wanted to be bigger and be stronger, even when he was a little baby. Let's see that first slide. There's Alex as a little baby. And he wanted to be stronger because he was tired of getting sand kicked on him at the beach. And he worked at it because he has a lot of motivation. And pretty soon, you know what he became? Let's see that second slide. There's Alex. So you haven't seen Alex without his shirt on, but he takes his shirt off. You'll be surprised. That's what he did because of that work he did when he was a little kid. Now, also, when Alex was a little boy, he loved music. And he was a big fan of the Jackson 5. But it wasn't enough to be a fan of the Jackson 5. He wanted to be in the Jackson 5. Let's see that next slide. So he changed the band to the Jackson 6. And it's a nice afro over there. Now, you know, we all know Alex has now succeeded and run for office and been successful. But, you know, to run for office, you have to aspire and emulate other people. So people that are in higher offices or in higher positions, Alex always tried to emulate those people. And because of who he emulated is one of the reasons why he got to where he is today. Let's see that next slide. So there he is, Alex, and it's a nice hairdo. And look, it got you where you are today. And right now, where you are, let's show that next slide. You, of course, are the king of Hawthorne. So let's hear it for Alex. Just having a little fun, just a little fun. Now, you know, Alex, by the way, he likes to have fun. So what he wanted to do today is, so he gave me a riddle. And whoever gets the riddle, I want you to raise your hand, and if you get it right, you get a free dinner with Alex. Alex paying for it, wherever you want. And so don't yell it out. You got to raise your hand, and I got to call you. And if you don't, then you're paying for the dinner. So let's see. Here's just a little riddle, just a regular little riddle. Two girls were born on the same day, same time, same month, same year, to the same mother. But they're not twins. How come? Raise your hand. Boy, this is a dumb group of people, I tell you. Nobody has the answer to that? Well, let me see your hand. Somebody there? Okay. What is it? Okay, is this too hard for you? I got another hand over there. No, I said they're not twins. You owe Alex a dinner. You owe Alex a dinner, Don. I'm going to give it one more shot, and then I'm going to another riddle. All right. You owe Alex another dinner. Okay. Here's an easier one. What has one eye but cannot see? A needle. You won a dinner with Mayor Vargas. So pick an expensive place. Okay. We have a wonderful event today, the main event, Alex Vargas. I'm the opening act, so I'll get out of here pretty quick. We can't have an event like this without sponsors. So let me quickly recognize the sponsors. Hold your applause till the end. The diamond sponsors, we have Blackwood Real Estate, California Water Service, Finance Auto, SpaceX. The gold sponsors, Chevron, Hawthorne Community Television, Republic Services, South Bay Ford Lincoln. The silver sponsors, Active Security Solutions, Sentinella Hospital, Clear Channel Outdoor, Golden State Water Company, Imperial Projects, South Bay Workforce Investment Board, that's pretty good, U.S. Tow Hawthorne. The bronze sponsor, Behavioral Health Services, Sentinella Valley Union High School District, City of Hawthorne, El Camino Small Business Development Center, Guy Hawker Realtors, Hawthorne Chamber, Hawthorne Education Foundation. Bronze sponsors, Hawthorne Municipal Employees Association, Jet Center, Los Angeles Advanced Air, LA Airports, McCormick Ambulance, PD and Associates, Republic Services, Sears Lumber, South Bay Association of Realtors, South County Labor, U-Haul Company of Los Angeles West, Union Bank, and Wiseburn Unified School District. Let's hear it for all of our sponsors. You want to do that now?
Yeah, do it.
Okay. All right, we have some plaques to give out. So will Finance Auto Sales come up? Blackwood Realty, SpaceX, and Hawthorne Chamber of Commerce?
No.
No?
SpaceX.
California Water Service. Okay, please come up and get your award.
It says the Hawthorne Chamber of Commerce formally recognizes and thanks Finance Auto Sales for being a diamond sponsor at the 2016 State of the City Address Luncheon and also for Blackwood Real Estate. For SpaceX, and they made this, I know that you all made this happen, but without the diamond sponsors, we wouldn't be able to have the food. So let's thank them.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you, sponsors. Could be triplets. There was the answer. Could be triplets. They're triplets. That's why they're not twins. Explain this to Nilo, will you please? Because I don't think he got it. Okay. We also have a list of dignitaries that are here today, and I want to recognize them for taking time out of their busy schedules to be here. Hold your applause to the end, but when I call your name, stand up, and then we'll give everybody a rousing hand of applause at the end of it. We have the 41st Treasurer of the United States, Rosario Marin, Ruben Morales, former deputy assistant to President George W. Bush and director of the White House Intergovernmental Affairs. Jerome Horton, chairman, California State Board of Equalization. Assemblymember David Hadley, 66th Assembly District. For the Hawthorne contingent, of course, you're going to hear from Mayor Alex Vargas in a few minutes. Alex is here. Mayor Pro Tem Angie English, Angie. Councilmember Nilo Michelin. Councilmember Olivia Valentine. Councilmember Hadar Awad. City Clerk Norb Huber. City Manager Arnie Shadbar. From the City of Inglewood, Mayor James T. Butts, Football Butts Jr., City of Inglewood. Is Jim here? Councilmember Alex Padilla, Councilmember Eloy Morales Jr., City Clerk Yvonne Horton. From the great city of Lawndale, we have Mayor Robert Pullen Miles, who's also representing Assemblymember Autumn Burke. Councilmember Dan Reed, City Clerk Bernadette Suarez. From El Segundo, Mayor Suzanne Fuentes. From the City of Manhattan Beach, Mayor Mark Burton. From the great city of Lomita, Mayor Pro Tem Mark Warnick. City of Gardena, Councilmember Tasha Serta. Santa Monica, Mayor Tony Vasquez. From Cudahy, Councilman Jack Guerrero. City of Linwood, Mayor Edwin Hernandez. City of San Fernando, Mayor Antonio Lopez. City of Chino Hills, Vice Mayor Ray Marquez. City of La Puente, Councilmember David Argudo. City of Brea, Councilman Stephen Vargas. Some relation, Alex? Oh, okay. From the El Camino Community Board of Trustees, Vice President John Vargas, as another relative. And the brand spanking new president of El Camino College, Dr. Dina Maloney. Dina? From Sentinela Valley Union High School District, we have the president, Hugo Rojas. We have board member Gloria Ramos, board member Daniel Urrutia, board member Maricela Ruiz, and the superintendent, Dr. Gregorio O'Brien. From Wiseburn, board president Israel Mora, vice president Joanne Caneda, board member Roger Benuelos, Nelson Martinez, board member, and the superintendent, Dr. Dom Johnstone. From the Hawthorne School Board, we have the president, Alex Montero, board member, Dr. Eugene Crank, superintendent, Dr. Helen Morgan. From the Baldwin Park Unified School District, Teresa Vargas, another relative? Oh my God. Blanca Rubio, board member. From the Coast Community College District, Jim Moreno, Board of Trustees. We have from the board, from the West Basin Municipal Water District, Don Deere, Don. And we have Gloria Gray, Gloria. We have board member from the Valley County Water District, Margarita Vargas, another relative? Oh my God, we got so many relatives here. And we have not one, but two former assembly members here. We have Steve Bradford, and we have Warren Furutani. And because we're in Hawthorne, we have some former officials here. Former Mayor Larry Guidi, with a broken leg. We have former Mayor Guy Hawker. We have former council member Pablo Catano, and we have former councilman Gary Parsons. There he is. And we also have the chair of South County Labor, godfather of labor, Mr. Ray Cordova. Ray? Okay, let's have a hand for all of our officials that are here today. We're gonna take a break. This half of the room is going here. Food's ready? Food's ready? Yes? No, food's not ready. What the hell you want me to do up here? Anybody know a good joke? I tell you what though, I tell you what we could do. We could show that video before lunch. How's that, Patricia? Can we get that video? All right, we're gonna show a little video about Hawthorne, and then we're gonna have lunch, and then the main event, okay? Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
This city has done a total transformation. It's a pleasure to do business in the city of Hawthorne. It's the gem of the South Bay, in my opinion.
We're open. Thank you so much.
It's always a wonderful feeling to know that Hawthorne is growing. We're headed in the right direction through not only the economic developments in the city, but just like this here today, Flights Sports Grill and Bar.
Along with a large selection of food, Flights also offers 40 beers on tap and 10 others in bottle.
It looks really good in here. And the fact that Hawthorne has a craft brewery spot, it's actually pretty cool.
We consider ourselves business friendly. Hawthorne is open for business and we want business here and we want fine restaurants here. So I am so delighted to see another fine restaurant in Hawthorne.
Cheers! A normal household can mount this on their garage or on the outside wall of their house, and it doesn't take up any room. It's flat against the wall. It has all of the integrated safety systems. It's designed to work very well with solar systems right out of the box.
Tesla's home battery is named the Powerwall and offers independence from the utility grid and the security of an emergency backup. Each Powerwall comes in 10 kilowatts and are sufficient enough to power most homes during peak evening hours.
It's all about Hawthorne ingenuity. It's all about Hawthorne engineering and the company right here changing the world. I think it's awesome.
The power packs at Tesla prove their efficiency.
Starting a new chapter for Hawthorne, and that's the kind of same way I want this council to move forward. Is it's a clean slate. Whatever happened in the past happened, and it's time for us to all just kind of work together and push the city to the new vision that we have.
City officials attended a ribbon-cutting ceremony to officially open the new hangars.
Together with the Jet Center owners and the city of Hawthorne and yours truly, we've been able to work with all together to be able to bring these expansions here to the city of Hawthorne.
It took $6 million in private funds to construct these 21,000 square foot hangars.
Well, the businesses that are here, especially at the airport, have really invested a lot of money into making this a great airport.
It makes me really happy to know that businesses like SpaceX want to stay here in the city of Hawthorne, that they're investing in the city of Hawthorne. The parking structure that we see right here to my right is a testament to that, that their numbers are growing when it comes to employees, that they're needing to invest in their own infrastructure to support their business. I mean, their growth is awesome. I'm excited, my council's excited, and the community's excited.
Showing you another great project that you should be proud of. More importantly, we're working hard to lift Hawthorne in positive economic challenges and ways, but more importantly, working together along on the council to bring you all the best that we can in Hawthorne.
1, 2, 3.
I had a meeting with the Galaxy over the Halloween event and mentioned, hey, if you guys ever want to build futsal courts, we would love to do that. And Lauren from the Galaxy was like, well, as a matter of fact, we might want to do that.
A 3-year dream of Sergeant Chris Konyak and funded by Chevrolet through its Beautiful Possibilities program and the LA Galaxy Foundation now allows soccer to be played in this local park.
There's a huge amount of children, adults, teens that love to play soccer here in the city of Hawthorne. They would find any location that they could in our parks, sometimes even in the tennis courts. And of course, this wasn't the proper types of facilities to play soccer, but now we have official regulation-sized futsal courts here in the city of Hawthorne.
It feels amazing to have opened up the new football fields. You know, they're three beautiful fields and they're not vacant tennis courts, you know, so it gives this community and this neighborhood a home to play the beautiful game. It's just a blessing and it's just an honor just to participate and be involved with the city of Hawthorne.
We want to invite communities at large to visit our parks in Hawthorne and know that we have soccer fields.
I'll be out here playing with the kids, you know, I'm going to do whatever I can to help the kids in this environment and this neighborhood. And if my name is called, I'm here, you know, I'm here to help.
Giassi, one of our great players, is from Hawthorne himself, and now he's a professional soccer player. So giving kids the opportunity to play soccer, to see that a big soccer player is here from their own community will be incredible.
Today we have the grand opening of TJ Maxx in Hawthorne at Ocean Gate, and we're thrilled to know that another retail store is in our community and providing some goods and services to the people of Hawthorne.
I think this is a wonderful addition to our community. This whole area is just filled with wonderful stores for people to shop, Home Depot, Toys R Us. I mean, we are very, very grateful to have all these wonderful stores, and now we have TJ Maxx, and they are going to be a wonderful new addition to our shopping venue.
1, 2, 3. All right. Come on in, Blaze Pizza.
When I heard that Blaze Pizza was coming here to the city hall, I was extremely excited because it's like my favorite pizza. I had to drive to other cities like Southgate, Torrance, and Culver City. And now when I heard that the Blaze Pizza was going to be coming here, I just extremely excited. And you know, I'm excited that they're here, that I could just drive a mile or two, and that I could have my favorite pizza here in one spot.
The more ribbon cuttings we do as a city, the better that we become. And it shows the community that we are hard at work ensuring that they have good sit-down restaurants and that we're trying to bring the community in as well.
Okay, before we start, they said they need like 3 more minutes. I would like our committee that helped put this together to please stand and be recognized. The committee, where are you? You're all out there? Where are you? Cheryl? Charisse? Where's the committee? B?
Hey, Cheryl helped out as a minute. Cheryl, stand up a minute. I'm gonna tell you something about Cheryl. So, I mean, I have a very smart staff. So she got through a few weeks ago fixing a lamp next to her bed. And then she went to sleep.
How would you know that?
How would I know? That's a good question. I don't have an answer. That's what she told me. Anyway, her eyes get dry. So she always puts stuff in her eye to moisten her eye. So she reached over and she put crazy glue in her eye. I swear to God, put crazy glue in her eye. So luckily she had her lens, her contact lens in, or else it would have been stuck to her eye. So she was able to take the contact lens out quickly, and about a week later, she was able to open her eye and come to work to help get this event. So let's have a hand for Crazy Glue, Cheryl Singh. Now is the food ready?
One more minute. Okay, so I'm trying to think of things to do while they're telling me it's going to be okay in a minute. So what I would like to do quickly is for our city council to come stand up here so you really know who our city council are. Angie, Hadar, Nilo, Olivia. Come on up. Oh, well, our mayor. All right.
Hi,
I didn't say the mayor because he's already going to be coming up and speaking in a few minutes. No, I know. So as you know, this is our city council, Nilo Michlin. Let's give him a hand.
This is the appropriate time.
Okay. Nilo, you want to say something real quick?
Welcome to the new Hawthorne. We're bringing in a lot of businesses. Nothing was going on with the Hawthorne Mall for 15 years. We're moving forward with that. Nothing was going on with Hawthorne Boulevard for a long time. We're moving forward with that, so we're very excited. And we're working together as a team. Thank you for coming, and thank you for all the businesses that supported us.
Good afternoon. I'd like to just thank the Chamber of Commerce and obviously our Mayor Vargas for his first annual State of the City address. I'd like to just thank all those that made it possible, and more importantly, all of you that are here. If you could to just look out of all of the people that are here, it's a great turnout, and look forward for Hawthorne's future that is very prosperous. Thank you so much.
Good afternoon. Thank you all for coming so much. I want to say thank you to our wonderful staff. You are the glue who keeps this city together. Thank you to SpaceX for coming here. You're going to help us become technology and aerospace. You're recreating our technology and aerospace footprint in the South Bay. Thank you to all of our visitors, our sponsors, and thank you to all our new businesses. And as you can see, we are well on our way to making Hawthorne a destination city in the South Bay. Thank you.
And our youngest ever on our city council, and he has laryngitis and can't speak, but let's give him a hand, Hadar.
Voice is a little raspy, so I'll keep it short. But I wanted to thank everyone for coming out today. Excited to be on the council and excited to kind of bring this youthfulness to the council and putting us in this new direction. I'm gonna keep it short, I can barely talk, but thank you all for coming today.
Okay, all right, thank you so much, we're ready to eat. Okay, so what we're gonna do is the diamond, everyone that's on the first two rows, half, split it in half, and you go first, and then another two sets, and another two sets until we're all getting our food. So the first five rows, split it in half, and there's on each side. Thank you.
The 41st Treasurer of the United States, as I mentioned before, Rosario Marin, is here today, and she's gonna come up in a minute and introduce the mayor. But Rosario is a compassionate mother, dedicated public official, and consummate advocate for the disadvantaged and with peoples with disabilities. She has served for 22 years at the local, state, and national level. In addition, she is author of Leading Between Two Worlds. Most recently, she worked for Old Republic Title and a default management services company as vice president for business relations. She oversaw the efforts to expand into new markets and government contracts. Previously, she served in Governor Arnold Schwarzenegger's cabinet as Secretary of the State and Consumer Services Agency from 2006 to 2009, where she oversaw the state's civil rights enforcement, consumer protection, and the licensing of 2.4 million Californians in more than 255 professions. In 2001, she was appointed by George W. Bush and unanimously confirmed by the U.S. Senate to be the 41st Treasurer of the United States, where she oversaw the United States Mint and Bureau and Engraving. So, you know, ladies and gentlemen, if you have money in your wallet that's old, and there's a lot of politicians here who don't like to spend their money, so if you open up your wallet, you might find an old $1 bill with Rosario's signature on it, like this one. And if you have it, our mayor will give you $2 for it. So you should look in your wallet. Miss Marin has done so many things. Her bio reads like a novel, but let me introduce to you a wonderful person, Rosario Marin.
Well, that was really, really nice, Jan. It's awesome. I was afraid that I needed to come in and start singing like he did. So,
You wouldn't want me to do that because everybody will be gone and the mayor wouldn't appreciate that. I am really delighted, and it's a real honor for me to be here to introduce your mayor. When I was asked if I was willing to do this, I said absolutely. I've known Alex for a few years now. We've been in the trenches together. And one of the things that I've been going around, and I know that there are actually here people that I used to know when I was a council member and a mayor. Where's Sam? Is Sam gone? There, he was mayor of Maywood at that time. There are a number of people who public service is calling for. And when I met Alex, I knew that he was one of those people. Being a public servant is a calling. And for those of us that take very seriously the job of serving our community, my job is to ensure that they do their job. And I'm going to support them, and I'm going to cheer them, and I'm going to do everything I can. Because not just our communities and our cities, our state and our nation, they're hungry for that kind of leadership. They're hungry for that kind of civil service. And so when I met Alex a few years ago, I knew he was going to be a great public servant. And no wonder when he ran for mayor, the community rewarded his efforts, his work, with that vote of confidence. I can read you his bio, but you all here probably know it better than I do. But it is needless to say, he is the product of this community. He was born here. His proud parents are here. They have seen him all along his journey to serve this city. And it is truly amazing. You know, when you think about all the opportunities he had as a physics mayor, he could have gone anywhere. He could have taken a job, God knows, in any other state. But he chose to stay here. He chose to serve this community. And for that, we all should be grateful. I am so proud of you, Alex. You know, you are doing God's work here on earth. Whether you realize it or not, I do. I can see it, I can sense it, I can feel it. And the only thing that I can do is cheer you on. You go out there, you continue to do the good work that you've been doing all these years. Do it not just for your family, not just for your community, but our state needs leaders like you in every city. And I know you're joined here by many wonderful leaders throughout the South Bay, the Southeast. So go out there, continue to do the great work that the people of Hawthorne have entrusted you with. I know the future of Hawthorne is much brighter because of your mayor, Alex Vargas. God bless you, Alex.
How's everybody doing today? Good, good, good. I really appreciate everybody for being here. I want to thank all the residents who are here in the back, our commissioners, members of the community organizations that are here with us today, here front, in the back, in the middle. We're permeated with a lot of good quality Hawthornians that are here today, and I'm really excited about that. I thank all the elected officials who have come from afar, from as far as Chino Hills, and from as north as San Fernando, from the middle, like Cudahy, right? And Maywood and different locations that have come as assembly members, federal officials, former federal officials, et cetera. And all our business people in our community who's been here, is here and will be here, and we'll give them reason to be here. Thank you to the Chamber of Commerce, Patricia Donaldson, for putting this together. I appreciate her putting this together along with her committees and all the sponsors and everybody who's responsible for this. I want to introduce my family who's here. native Hawthornians. Well, my dad was immigrated from Mexico, my mom as well, but they chose to move to the city of Hawthorne in 1971. My mom, my dad, my sister Martha, her husband, our brother-in-law, Chris, and baby Adrian, who's the first nephew in our family, so we're really excited about that. My brother Gerard, or my brother John, but I know him as Johnny, so where's John? Please stand, John, because I want to do something real interesting. Earlier today, stay standing, please. Earlier today, you kind of heard that a lot of Vargases were mentioned, so I'm going to just have them stand up one by one and stay up standing. My brother John, he's the vice president of the El Camino College Board of Trustees, and he was a former school board member for the Hawthorne School District. Where's my tia Margarita? My aunt. That's my aunt right there. That really is my aunt. She's a board member for the Valley County Water District. And my cousin Teresa Vargas was supposed to be here, but she had a family emergency. But I have another board member in the Baldwin Park Unified School District. And my cousin Steven, where's my cousin Steven Vargas? Stand up. That's my cousin Steven. That's from our Puerto Rican side of the family. I guess when they were crossing the ocean, they said, hey, we want to kind of go to the beach area. You guys can go to that jungle area over there. Kind of humid over there. And myself, so definitely. There's Vargas is here. It's a family affair. We like to, you know, serve the community publicly, but don't be afraid if you see a Vargas move into your community, elected officials or assembly members. So again, thank you all for being here. And today I want to take a different approach in presenting the state of the city. Many times you guys hear that a lot of the mayors come up here in other cities, especially here in the city of Hawthorne in the last few years. Everything's great. Everything's jolly. You know, say jokes and try to like forget the reality of the situation. And there's reason why we're here and reason why we want to celebrate, but we also have to recognize where we've come from. Where have we been? And there's a lot to learn from that. Where are we? What have we experienced? What have we as a council inherited? We have inherited something. We have inherited a rough situation here in the city of Hawthorne economically. Some may even argue that that started 10, 20, 30 years ago even. And our city council has been mired in controversy. And you guys could take a look at it online. You could look at it at the Daily Breeze or whatever. You can talk to your neighbors. And maybe many of you are familiar with some of the issues that have bogged down our city when it comes to those things. But as a result of that, we had this last administration left us with the big situation, a $6.5 million deficit, which it was hard to balance the budget because we were having a hard time finding the necessary revenue to be able to balance that. So we inherited that, but there's a new spirit here in the city that I'm excited about. Unfortunately, with the situation with the $6.5 million budget deficit, there's drastic measures that we have to take, and that includes laying off people. And that includes pay reductions, furloughs. This is one of the most painful things that I experienced and some of my council members experienced when we had to do that, because it could have been prevented. Bad decisions, people walking through the city, coming through the city, and it's city council feeling it was just a little joyride or whatever. But let's not talk about that, because we're going to move on into why we have a lot of great things to look forward to here in the city of Hawthorne. And that doesn't happen just on our own. It's not the mayor only that does this. It's a team. And what I could tell you is that I feel a big harmony here in the city, a sense of peace with the employees, with the community leaders, with on the council. We feel a sense of peace. People are getting along. We disagree on issues, but we're able to talk about them and sort them out. So what I want to do is I want to ask each of my individual council members or Mayor Pro Tem, starting off with Mayor Pro Tem, if you could please stand. Mayor Pro Tem, Angie Reyes English, stay standing, please. Mayor Pro Tem, I ran with her about 6 years ago. We joined the city of Hawthorne, and over those years, what we've sensed and what we've gathered is that she has a sense of compassion for the community. She's familiar with a lot of the social issues here in the community, and she's able to bring to us a lot of resources because she's worked with, now she works with the LA City Council members, she's worked for the state, and she's worked along with federal federal agencies as well. So she's familiar with those issues, and she can bring those resources to the table. That's very important. That's an good element to have in the city. Thank you very much for helping us out in your service. Let's give a round of applause to her. Council Member Nilo Michelin, where is he? He's in the back again. I wish you were up here, man, but he's in the back. Council Member Michelin fights for what is right. He has a legal sense of what is right and wrong. And because he has experience as a lawyer, and now he works as a teacher just like me. He works with the public school district, I work with the charter, but we're able to share that compassion for our community because of that experience, and we're able to approach things similarly because of that. But I wanna thank you, Council Member Michelin, for joining me and joining together to be able to expose the improprieties that were taking place with specific members of our previous administration to show that there was a problem with our budget and that indeed we were right, we weren't crazy to imagine these things. And now we're repairing the situation with your help and with the help of the rest of the City Council. Thank you, Council Member Michelin. Councilwoman Olivia Valentine, can you please stand, ma'am? Councilwoman Olivia Valentine has served for the city for 4 years. She's back on the council, and she is a tireless advocate for economic development in the city of Hawthorne. She has her different business expos, a lot of seminars that she's put on. I've joined her in that. And that speaks well for the community because we have somebody that's focusing on that. We're all focusing on the same things, but we have delegated different tasks, and that's one that she's picked up, including the artistic side of the city of Hawthorne, promoting artistic awareness here in the city and trying to make Hawthorne a hub of art here in the South Bay. She also has the experience as a lawyer, so that's helpful when we're out there looking at the legalities of actions we're about to take so we can check and balance what we're about to do. So thank you, Council Member Olivia Valentine. He's trying to hide right there, come on. Council Member Hadar Awad, please stand, my friend. Let's give it up for him. Because he's the newest addition to the City Council, and we're really excited that he's here because he has a keen sense of business, because he's a business owner himself. He's experienced that here in the city, and he's aware of the different dynamics that have taken place in City Hall because he's in Hawthorne and he owns a business. So bringing that mix together to the City Council is awesome. It's an awesome mixture that will definitely benefit us. And I can definitely attest, things happen in closed session I can't talk about, but he has proven his mettle when it comes to addressing and solving problems with the City Council. Thank you very much for joining us, Council Member Hadar Awad. And I'm your mayor, I'm the fifth element of the City Council, and yeah, I'm the mayor, oh, okay. And I'm the one that's steering the ship. Sure, I'm the one that's steering the ship. But I can tell you this, that this council body that you see here today is all rowing that boat together, putting it back on track in the direction it should be going, to a level, to a direction of progress. So let me tell you what we're doing in order to rectify whatever situations we have seen economically. There's about three elements that we have identified action items that we're doing. The first component is the process. We're in the process of restructuring some of our debts and loans so that those terms will be favorable to the city. That's obviously going to be money that we're going to be able to put back into our coffers or not dish out. So that would be an immediate ability to close the gap of our budget. That's one of those items. We are also in the process of selling our old police station. We have a brand new one, but we have an old one too that we own the property. We're attempting to sell that, and eventually with the sale of that property and the development of a hotel and different restaurants and commercial activity that's going to take place, there's going to be sales tax revenue, TOT, and every different things that is going to benefit the city. That's short term. It's coming up soon, probably 2 or 3 years, but we're lining everything up to be able to bring us back on our feet. The Hawthorne Boulevard specific plan is something that we're really excited about because that's the element that deals with the Hawthorne Mall. Everybody's, what's gonna happen with the Hawthorne Mall? Well, let's mention all the other things that are gonna happen along Hawthorne Boulevard. Definitely we're gonna have a sense of community, and because people are going to be able to walk up and down Hawthorne Boulevard with the new developments that we're going to see along Hawthorne Boulevards from El Segundo to Rosecrans, where we're going to try to bring restaurants and try to make it a type of Colorado Boulevard here in the South Bay. That's what our vision is. Then north of El Segundo, we do have the Hawthorne Mall property, but before I go to that, let's discuss the Imperial Highway that's right behind me up here. We're trying to make that a hotel corridor to be able to take advantage of the situation. I want to congratulate my friends in the city of Inglewood for having the Rams come into the Inglewood. Let's give it up to them. But that takes a lot of work, and that's something that's definitely going to radiate towards our direction, where we're going to be able to benefit from all the fruits of that investment there. And having hotels where members of the community or visitors from out of town are going to go to and stay, they can stay in the city of Hawthorne. We'll give them other options. It's going to definitely be enough business for everybody. But let's elaborate more on the Hawthorne Mall site, which everybody's all buzzing about. At the March 8th City Council meeting, the Charles Company that owns the Hawthorne Mall showed a new mixed-use development that includes office space, luxury residential units, movie theaters, and an exciting new shopping area right in the heart of the city of Hawthorne. It's a multi-hundred million dollar investment that they're putting, and it's a project which will bring amenities and economic development to the city of Hawthorne. And it's gonna finally fill that hole in the community that everybody's been complaining about. Everybody's been saying that, you know, that's our golden opportunity. Well, it's right around the corner, folks, so let's be excited about that. But one of the things that we have to mention, though, say that there's still work to be done. It's not already set. It's not gonna, there's still work to be done. We need your support as residents, as business owners, as city councilmembers who continue pushing towards that to make that a reality, to see it through, because we're already turning the corner when it comes to this issue. And one of the biggest things was the Hawthorne Boulevard specific plan. This council, I'm telling you, this council is not obstructionist. This council is an action-based council. And I've had conversations with members of our city council, and we're happy and we're refreshed that we're able to do these things and not pay these pay-to-play things and all these little plays that are being played behind the scenes, because that never led us anywhere. We had this period of stagnation. But now we're seeing the growth with a lot of these other things that I'm probably going to mention really soon. So let's continue that, city council. I'm really proud of you guys, and I'm looking forward to continuing working with our council. Let's hear it up, give it up for our council again. Let's talk about our Hawthorne Police Department, because we're really excited about them. We're proud of them because they're keeping us safe, and that's what helps us move forward. A safe community allows for business developers and business peoples to come to the city of Hawthorne. That's really essential. 2015 was another year for our police department that included about 36,000 service calls. I wouldn't want 360,000. 36,000 service calls. At the same time, they've created a lot of community-based programs. The creation of the Gardena Hawthorne Mental Evaluation Team was created to address the mental issues that are taking place on the field, because we need people out there. There's a lot of people that are homeless, okay? Yeah, people can't just say, just scoot on over, go here, you can't be there. No, we wanna address what those issues are right when we're there, get them the right resources, being able to pull out a copy of a list of shelters of mental services, etc. And our police department is doing that because we feel so strongly about that, getting them the help that they need. Our Metro team last year, they shut down a lot of business. Well, not a lot, but they shut down businesses that are dealing with illegal activity, just like any other city. Every council member here knows. And every city has issues sometimes with some gambling, illegal gambling, and narcotic sales. Our team here at the Hawthorne Police Department is taking care of that. So we're really proud of you guys for knocking them out. Our narcotics team itself last year seized about 45 kilos of cocaine and over 2 tons of illegal marijuana. We're taking care of business and rooting those guys out of here. Our community affairs team also did the following great work into 2016. So a lot of stuff actually has been happening in like the last 4 months that we've been here. For example, the promotion of the Coffee with a Cop program internationally, well, Sweden, Norway, really far away, right? Norway, Holland. all over Europe and probably in Asian countries coming up soon, Latin American countries as well. So we're really proud of that effort. Basically, that means that our any police department, a suggestion to all my fellow council members and mayors, just host a morning breakfast where you invite the community and offer free coffee and have your police agencies meet with the community. It definitely helps build bridges, and there's a trust that's being built right there. They've also joined North Hawthorne Community Association in promoting the idea of taco with a cop, not just the mug. You could get a little taco with extra, well, I'm not gonna say extra sauce on that. And they've also obtained sponsorship for the City of Hawthorne's events from the LA Kings, the LA Galaxy, Chivas, and the LA Lakers. Do you guys remember who they are? They've also built a strong relationship with our Islamic Center, a Muslim community that's here in the City of Hawthorne. That's very, very important. And they've also hosted an LGBT community information night because our community is an inclusive one. They've also promoted after-school programs such as the Hawthorne Force Youth Hockey Program. So that's interesting. Who would imagine that we could have some hockey here in the South Bay? It's really warm here sometimes. And they've also established a presence on the social media that's very comprehensive. I don't see this with a lot of other communities, and I'm proud of it. We're proud of it, is that their presence is on Facebook, Twitter, Nextdoor, and Snapchat. So that's pretty comprehensive if you ask me. And Scotty, the police dog, why didn't you guys bring Scotty today? We could have got him a plate. He doesn't like lasagna, okay. Scotty is our police service dog that is our representative of the City of Hawthorne's police department of our, you know, ourselves. It's a service dog that we're taking to the kids, to the seniors, to those who might be disabled, to be able to bridge the gap between the police department and our community. That's very important because trust, there's a mistrust that sometimes exists between policing agencies and the community. For sometimes the obvious reasons that people are not happy with that relationship, and Scotty helps ease that through. Let's talk about public works. Our public works department has been completing a $3 million street improvement program with the pavement of over 6 miles of local streets and the laying of 15,000 tons of asphalt. So you can just try to get a grasp of that in your head, how much that probably is. It's a lot. They've completed the first phase of a $4 million intersection widening and traffic signal project at the intersection of Northrop Avenue and Crenshaw Boulevard to improve the traffic there. Obviously, we have SpaceX there, and we need to, and so many people are coming to work, and a lot of activities taking place over that. We have to take care of that. The designing of $22 million worth of capital improvement projects, including ones on El Segundo Boulevard, Prairie Avenue, and the second phase of the Hawthorne Boulevard improvement that's north of El Segundo all the way to Imperial Highway. We completed the one from Rosecrans to El Segundo, and now we're gonna finish it up from El Segundo over to Imperial Highway. So I'm looking forward to seeing those plans and maybe being able to choose what the flora should be. So that's something to be proud of. To be completed this year, our traffic signal improvements along Inglewood Avenue and the widening of Marine Avenue at Aviation. Together, this will equal about $5 million worth of capital improvement projects. The Public Works Department will also be done very soon with installation of over 500 screens and filters in our catch basin inlets, trying to make sure that we protect our environment by being able to get all the stuff that doesn't need to go into the ocean. This is all in addition to the regular annual work that our Public Works Agency does. They replace 54,000 square feet of sidewalks. They've replaced about 300 feet of sewer lines. They constantly are cleaning and maintaining the 130 miles actually of sewer pipes. That's a lot. Removing over 3 million square feet of graffiti because we have an awesome graffiti control program here in the City of Hawthorne. As you can see, the city staff works hard to keep the city running smoothly. We do as much as we can with the resources we have. And you know what? I commend our Public Works Department, all our city employees. Let's have all the city employees who are here please stand up so we can acknowledge them for all the hard work they do, including our city department heads. We have our city manager, Arnie Schodber, our police chief, Chief Fager, our attorney, our human resources manager, Dave Roberts. Where's Greg McLean from the planning department? Thank you so much. And you know what? We thank you again for sacrificing. You know, some of the stuff that's going on was unfortunate, but thank you for your sacrifices to keep the city running and being provide and maintaining the quality of service that we provide to the community. We're really proud of you guys. So we work with the SpaceX. SpaceX is our big, big corporate company here in the city of Hawthorne. SpaceX is expanding and providing over jobs for 3,500 people here in the city of Hawthorne. 3,500. I remember when it started off at 500, like about 5, 6, 7 years ago. So it's grown by, I don't know, 200, 300, 400%. SpaceX is increasing the size of their physical footprint here in the city of Hawthorne, recently expanding to 29 buildings within the city. They started off with the main hangar. Now they're renting out or buying properties adjacent to SpaceX because of the growth that's taking place. They're expanding into the large buildings on the west side of Jack Northrop Avenue, formerly used by Triumph Aerospace Company. The city of Hawthorne has completed a key intersection widening and traffic signal improvement project at the intersections of Rocket Road and Jack Northrop with Crenshaw Boulevard. You guys saw that up here when we were doing the ribbon cutting. They have a 7-story tall parking structure because all the employees are coming to the city of Hawthorne to work. And of course, those employees are gonna wanna go shop and dine and even live here. So that's something we're gonna definitely have to accommodate for, and something that's gonna be positive for the city of Hawthorne. A new group of individuals, engineers. They're not that bad people, are they, Angie? In addition to the rocket and space production, SpaceX is bringing an exciting student-focused competition program here to the city of Hawthorne in the summer of 2016, and that's the SpaceX Hyperloop Pod Competition. The Hyperloop concept is a revolutionary new form of high-speed transportation, and what that is basically those pods that would travel along those tubes, and somehow there will be some propulsion system that will send them along without a lot of friction, without a lot of things to slow them down. So making a 6-hour trip up to Sacramento or San Francisco take about an hour. So that's revolutionary, and that investigation and research is taking place here in the city of Hawthorne. So that's a big deal, and I'm pretty sure Elon Musk and his people are gonna make that happen. And we, the city of Hawthorne, have to support that, and we will support that through our administration here and all the members of the council and all the business owners who surround the city of Hawthorne, throughout the city of Hawthorne. We all work together. Let's round this off with the new notable businesses that have come to the city of Hawthorne. And for us, it's a big thing, because what this indicates to the city, to the residents, and to the city council, is that people are coming to the city of Hawthorne. They see that the climate, the political climate, is where it should be. No political climate, non-existent. It's just about business. And so they're seeing that, and they're moving to the city of Hawthorne. For example, TJ Maxx, Honey Boba, long lines if you go over there. You can see what I mean, how great this is. A new Starbucks over here at Hawthorne Boulevard and Imperial Highway coming soon. And Blaze Pizza, my favorite pizza, you guys know. Meat Lover's Pizza, the new barbecue chicken one. I like that one too. So the Futsal Center, let's talk about that. I didn't talk about it, but Sergeant Chris Cognac was able to talk to the city, and we supported him in this, is being able to bring the LA Galaxy to help support us in refurbishing our tennis courts to be able to allow the community, its children and its adults, like myself, I like to play soccer, to be able to use those tennis courts in a futsal configuration. So now if you drive by there every evening, they're always full. Always full, right? So that's something we have to be proud of. And Gyasi Sardis is a native of the city of Hawthorne. He grew up here. We went to Luzinger High School with the Mayor Pro Tem's daughters. So there's connections here. This person is rooted here. And Gyasi Sardis came and inaugurated that facility. Gyasi Sardis is a proud member of our United States national soccer team. You're probably gonna see him in a in a game against Guatemala coming, and that's Gyasi Sardis, who grew up right across the street here, literally, right across the, El Segundo Boulevard here on Doty or something. So let's be proud of him, let's wish him well, and congratulations to our team who was able to obtain that added benefit. So a very new announcement that I don't know if anybody really knows, but we're excited about. And this is our new announcement for this year, I would say, when it comes to businesses, is that a new Amazon Fulfillment Center is going to be coming to Hawthorne very soon. Although their coming is taking place in phases, it will ultimately grow to occupy about 170,000 square feet of warehouse space at 2815 El Segundo Boulevard, right up the street right here, in a super large warehouse. We're excited about that, and we hope you are too. And as you all know, and I'll repeat again, our neighbor has a new football team that's coming to the city of Inglewood. We congratulate them again, and we're definitely going to be building development on our northern part of our community, and even in the towards the central part of our community, to be able to welcome all that those visitors who are going to be coming and all the potential business that we could receive. It's going to be good for everybody here. Of all these projects that we have, there's going to be an infusion of new people to the city of Hawthorne, and we must be prepared on all fronts. We will all need to be ready for a vibrant future for economic growth and technological innovation here in the city of Hawthorne. There's a lot of startups that are going to be coming to the city of Hawthorne. We already got some people that are applying for development permits. We have people who are applying for business permits, and from what we see that's on the horizon, we're going to be having a technological hub created here in the city of Hawthorne coming soon. But of course, as I mentioned, we recognize the situation in which we were, that we inherited, and now the way I can best describe the situation is we're going to be getting up off the ground on our feet. And now in this next coming years, we're going to start walking forward, and pretty soon we're going to be running forward. And I want to describe, these are my final comments, in which I want to describe what we're experiencing here in the city of Hawthorne is an era of peace, order, and prosperity. And let me tell you why I mentioned those three terms. Peace, because what you see on the council, you know, turn on the TV, we get business done right away. We're not going back and forth. We'll have a disagreement, but we'll take care of it. We'll discuss it. And it's not politics as usual. We rejected the politics of the past, which was petty. And we have vestiges of that still. And we want to eliminate that. That doesn't have any part here in the city of Hawthorne anymore, because we want to propel our community forward. We have the team to do it. From all the members of our city council that I mentioned, you guys can see, talk to your employees, talk to our staff, there's peace. They're not nervous, oh, am I gonna lose my job? Is there gonna be something crazy gonna happen? We're building trust with our community, with our city hall employees, and that's awesome. Order, because we all are just, what we're doing is just doing things simply the right way, following proper operating procedure. Following the processes that are on the book. Letting those processes take place, because that's what's gonna benefit us. Without the interference of council members, of people from the special interest trying to infuse themselves into the different departments and changing things around. Let things take their course. Let there be order in the city of Hawthorne and the way we do things. And that's gonna reap benefits for the community. And when it comes to the next thing, which is prosperity, we already seen elements of that. People are coming to the city of Hawthorne. They're not turning away, they're coming. The planning department's getting a lot of inquiries, a lot of people looking at different things. People are excited about the specific plan and what that entails. So that's why when we have peace on the council and in the community, when the political scene, and when there's order, we'll have prosperity. So we need to promote all those three elements here in the city of Hawthorne, and we're all excited. So I really believe that we've turned a corner and we're on the right track. I'm super excited about that. And I wanna thank each and every one of you for playing a part in that, bringing back Hawthorne to a position where it should be, right back on track to prosperity. So thank you all very much for being here today. Thank you so much.
Excellent, Mayor. Excellent. Okay, we're just about ready to go. I want to thank Jan Vogel and Ray Cordova. They're most wonderful people around. And as you can see, my husband was unable to attend, but I have another husband that's here today. There he is. Okay, I want to thank you very much, Chief. Thank you so much for what you do for our city. And Arnie, our city manager, we couldn't do business without both of you. So thank all of you. Have a wonderful day. Take care.